variation in the program or progress اللي صار بالاسبوع الاول والاسبوع الثاني والاسبوع طبعا البيم is a game changer as well. البيم is affecting all the previous technologies. So in today's session, session is the full follow, we will be seeing and witnessing how those technologies are disrupting the way each and every one of us is doing this current business as we speak. Some of the technologies, apologies for the quality in the presentation, the general design, our parametric design. As you come as an architect now, your job is made much simpler. All we need to do is to tell the computer what are the parameters and what are the criteria that you want to use to develop your building. So you can put your criteria, what are the criteria, the height of the building, the insulation, the window to wall ratio, the carbon footprint, and so on, and the computer will generate for you hundreds and thousands of options that you can start narrowing down. This applies for buildings, this applies for stadiums, this applies for infrastructure projects. Well, we will, infrastructure session, you will see how easy now is it to design a road, to design an intersection around the block. It's all just put set the parameters that you want to design for, and the system will generate for you all the possible options and will optimize the way. So what we are seeing here, this is a stadium that's being designed. You're putting the parameters that you want to design for, and the computer will generate for you options. Now, if you want to do this manually, this will take you weeks. Now, in just a couple of hours, you have thousands of options that you can narrow down into two or three or four options that you can take into further detailing and design at a later stage. If you're not leveraging such technologies, you will be left behind, because many of the companies that are doing such things are currently leveraging those technologies. We can recommend move to prefabrication. You bring the rooms and so on, similar to how my kids now will use the building blocks to build the tools. This building, although it is one of the most difficult buildings in the world, it is very resistant to seismic activity. It can resist the 9 degree earthquake. It has a very clear and very safe environment. And also, it is very easy to manage and maintain. And many of the things are being referred. Hakim, I'm on this thing, depending on the introduction of the doors and the construction field. But this is just a sample. The Rabbi Al-Adas University in Las Vegas has shown many of those robots in action. The Rabbi Al-Adas construction fields in many places in Scandinavia or the US, you will see that there are many robots that are now invading the construction site. حكينا أيضاً على موضوع convergence between industries. The construction industry is trying to catch up with the manufacturing industry, where robots have now played a key role in the way manufacturing projects are being done. They are in this puzzle, three areas that happen and change the way we do our business. The move from paper to AutoCAD. Not a lot of intelligence have been added. Yet whatever was being done on paper is now being done, what was done on AutoCAD. This was back in the 80s and early 90s. Then we moved into what we call the era of connection, era of optimization, surrounded by the model, multidisciplinary analysis, simulation, that we can use to generate drawings, to do analysis, and simulation. Now we are moving to the era of connection, where it doesn't matter where you are, you can work and leverage the power of the car, the power of connectivity between the various sites. Not only this, I mean, we can leverage the power of connected devices. And there are some estimates that say that 40 million connected devices will be available by 2020, and this number will increase by 10 million every year afterward. Are you able to put a small sensor that will be able to capture the information of the pressure, of the temperature, of the movement of people, and bring this information into your model and do some simulation and analysis, and accordingly take the right decision-informed decision. But some of the companies are still in the area of documentation. Some of the companies have moved into the area of optimization. Very few are in the area of connection. The majority are somewhere between the area of documentation and the area of connection. Our role is to push companies and organizations into the area of connection. Then we have to start all the development system that has happened over the last 20 or 30 years. The construction sector is still one of the sectors that employ lots of people, but there are lots of inefficiencies. Material waste, around 40%. An average schedule of running on our projects, 20%. An average cost increase per project, 3-5%. So despite all the advancement that has happened, we are still facing big issues in the construction sector. And this is mostly due to the fact that although our technology has changed, but the way we do business is still the same. And there are lots of disconnection that's happening in the way we do business. In the past, we used to get a hardware that was in AutoCAD, for example, generate here, share the information with